On. So the idea is to bring back the small shop that was part of what Adams looked like 80 and 100 years ago.
Just a clarification, REI is a co-op that's very alive and based in the West. I think you're thinking of Eastern Mountain Sports.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. So once you have all of a sudden 10 of these stores open on Main Street, you all of a sudden can justify a Starbucks. And the other thing is what's possible here is a store that relates to the magic that's created by Ilver Morning, J.K. Rowling, Harry Potter. People know what geocaching is here. So we think, so it's not allowed in Massachusetts on the Appalachian Trail, but it's allowed alongside it. So we think that the Glen lends itself to a huge opportunity, and if we were to make these, this, for example, into a cache cave, this is in a community where geocaching is very much alive, these can be very big draws from miles around where people would come. And this is a glass geocache coin that people hide in a tree or under a rock. And in this case, it could be custom made with a Harry Potter figure, and these would be very collectible and sought after by thousands of families on weekends and otherwise. You know, in Europe, geocaching is a very important program to get kids away from their TV screens and computers. And this way the family kind of plays together and still there's a high-tech element. The other thing we want to explore here is a certain type of school called a forest school. So it started in Europe where I went to school in Denmark, and young kids from four or five to 10 spend the full day outdoors. No plastic toys are allowed. You're outdoors, whether it's raining or snowing or whatever. And all of a sudden, kids get to learn things and be stronger in many different ways. The closest one here is in Saratoga Springs. Ithaca has one in the Boston area, there was one or two. But it's not common yet in America, but there are 1,000 in Europe. The other thing, I have a home in Italy, and the agritourism is a big deal. People who have the farms and so on, and Adams is rich in having a lot of beautiful landscape. Tourists like to have real experiences rather than even restaurants if they're going to be here only for a few days. So there really are some interesting opportunities. So this is my ending one, but basically this is what the future could be. Anybody have any questions?
So you proposed parts of this to Adams already?
Yeah, everything.
Everything. And what was the response?
Well, I think they like it. They want to see. It doesn't respond to their plan because it doesn't have a sleeping bags and so on. But, you know, we have a meeting this week and it's an ongoing conversation. Hopefully something positive will happen.
Yeah, now, you started with the campground thing, not you really expanded it into the town, etc. So, are you going to start in sections?
Okay, so the town. What's approved now is the campground. But that doesn't mean we can't already bring in and put up a sign and start the economic development part, which is to attract bicycle enthusiasts to open up shops. That can be done parallel. So the school exists and it has to be cleaned and renovated and so on. So all these things can begin to happen simultaneously. The thing that is projected to happen a little bit later, possibly, is the hotel and there's an amphitheater that's also been proposed that Massmoken may manage, which is a 2,500 person amphitheater where they might hold concerts and things like that.
In the Glen?
Huh?
In the Glen?
In that 50 acres that has been approved. Yeah, that site plan is available in town. But the Nature Center, we think, you know, by spring, will, you know, serious work, engineering and so on will have been done.
Who's gonna build the Nature Center?
That's gonna go out for bid, but basically the funding for that has been approved. It's been bought, right, Dick?
Yes, it was part of a statewide bond for one of our projects. It was approved, so approximately $5 million has been earmarked for that center.
So that's gonna happen?
Yes. Yeah, they had an RFP issue for that, and they had 10 or 12 architectural firms respond to it, so that part is moving forward.
So where is the Nature Center supposed to be going?
I'm gonna show it to you right here. So the Nature Center, if you're going on Gould Avenue and Gould Road, I should say, that it is to the right of the pond.
Up Teal Road?
No, it's right on Gould. So if you're going on Gould, you'll see it first by a pullover parking area.
Oh, right. Below the willows?
Yeah.
Between the pond and the willows?
To the right of the pond.
Right, to the right of the pond. So the willows are up the hill from the pond.
Yeah.
The pond's here.
Yeah.
And the willows,
yeah, the willows
are up the hill to the right. It's going to be somewhere in there?
To the right of the pond, not as far as the willows.
Not as far as the willows?
No. So that is a for sure thing. And the Audubon, the state have signed off on it, is going to have some classrooms. It's also going to be a Nordic ski center there. So there are a lot of things that could take place in that 11,000 square feet. But that parking has been approved, and that the architects are going to be selected, if they haven't already been. They will do the drawings, engineering, and then it'll go out to bid, and that's that'll happen. That'll be the first serious project on the
project. I just have one more question now. What's that going to do? I've been hiking around up in there for 60 years. And what's that going to do to my freedom to hike wherever I want?
No, the 11 acres, 50 acres is right at the beginning of Gould. And
it's right there where I used to hike.
Yeah, but you can keep on going without even looking at those. You can go on a trail without even looking at the Nature Center.
Right, but they've already turned some of the trails I used to like to walk on into superhighway.
Yes, that's true. But there's also today, the idea is that they want it to be attractive for, even for the future, for a horse.
But I can still, they're not going to limit my access,
no.
Essentially.
No.
That's what I'm concerned
yeah,
about.
Yeah, no, they won't. No, we want you to behave the way you did before.
Okay.
But there'll be a real bathroom there now, and so on. So.
All right. But the Historical Society was hesitant to get involved. There's so much tension or passion or something in the town.
The Historical Society didn't want to be here tonight because they just are stuck in the historical, so they're stuck in that bad history.
Right.
And they're not looking beyond. I don't have that in my blood, so
right.
I'm happy to look beyond it.
Yeah.
But I should mention, this is for me. I told the town very clearly that I'm not interested in anything here if I can't do this, because if it's just happening here, I think it has a chance of failing, just like all the other things that have taken place there over the past 50 years. Because without the action here in town, this is just a mass mocha unto itself, and the town isn't going to benefit, because there isn't enough hours in the day for people to experience the campground and then come to town.
Well, so are they interested in someone else developing the campground, or you developing it?
No, I want to do the whole thing.
The whole thing?
Yeah. Okay. That's the proposal. Obviously, I can't do it all on it.
You mentioned Central Park, and Central Park has kind of nothing in a way. Like, it has just trails and ponds, and what's around Central Park that sort of brings people to the 850 acres. Why, I'm curious, in your thinking, in your visionary thinking, why, and I'm not familiar, like, the Mass MoCA effect in terms of they just stayed secluded and didn't branch out. Why maybe you're not contacting those business owners of the empty storefronts and the potential bicycle shops? Why maybe, why aren't you concentrating on just the town and just leaving the bucolic glen as it is, like the Central Park as it is?
Yeah, because there's not, what's happened is that and the reason that all these other projects failed is that they weren't thought out well enough. And so the money was pumped into them, things got built or half built, and then it failed. Because there are not enough bodies in Adams by itself. You have to have a reason to bring people here. And so the Glen does that, but you need more in order to keep people there overnight. So people come now and go hiking, maybe camping, maybe skiing suspension, but they're not spending money on downtown.
And is there copyright infringement on Harry Potter?
Yes, for sure. And that's why, so we have to take the spirit and we have to negotiate with them. We hopefully will have something in place if we have a master plan that doesn't violate any of their issues.
And with Mass MoCA, that what's happening there didn't sort of filter out to...
No, and not yet. It's, you know, in fact, what interesting thing is they just, with this new addition of, so that it's now the largest contemporary art museum in the country, 150,000 additional square feet of space, the downtown is still suffering. And so they got Mass MoCA got a $150,000 grant from the Barr Foundation in Boston to study what can we do. They've never paid attention to it. So now, what can we do? And I think that if this thing got going, we would bring in the Barr Foundation and try to, because this is key, is to make this connect here. For me. So nobody submitted a proposal for the campground. We don't know what's going to happen with the other proposals that are going to come forth. But in my heart, I believe that because you're talking about only about 50 acres out of the 1,000 that's going to be touched here, that it has the potential of bringing in thousands of people who potentially might fall in love with the area. They might stay, just like happens in Stockbridge when they visit Kripalu or Tanglewood. And we are only 10 minutes away from Mass MoCA, Williams College. You know, it's really that close. I think that there's a good shot that this all could work in a nice, soft way without having a Hilton, and just make it busy and ugly.
Ralph, we have to segue into dinner.
Yeah.
If there's a final question.
Yeah, gentleman behind you.
Yeah. It's always been I wasn't around for most of the things. I was in a service during that period of time, and then I lived out of town. I lived in Colorado for 7 or 8 years, so I missed most of all the development things. You know, this started in the 70s with the ski area, and that was before they ever started building, is when I left. And while I was gone, they built the lift towers and all that, and almost finished and then failed. But it was my indication in the 70s when they started devoting more attention to the environmental studies and stuff like that, that was one of the causes for the most recent failure, or the last failure of some kind of development in the Glen.
Yeah, I think that's true.
Environmental impact
studies.
And my question is, is that all been resolved?
It's all been resolved. That's the only way I would get involved with this, and the town knows that. So they have spent 5 years negotiating with getting the plan, getting it going through wetlands, going through every single environmental, you know, hurdle, and it's all been now signed off on the state, the nature groups, and the town. It's a 90-year lease. That.
And what kind of time frame are we looking for this kind of development?
Well, we don't know. We know that the Nature Education Center has a shot of getting into the ground in 2019.
How many square feet on the Nature Education Center?
That's 11,000 square feet.
Okay, now.
Thank you, Ralph.
Yeah.
Patience while we fix this technology.